Welcome to Internal System Support's PeopleSoft Mileage and Travel Training. This video presentation is designed as a quick and easy way to get started with creating and submitting mileage and travel claims. In this course, we will discuss three main topics: how to set up claimant defaults, how to create and process a mileage or travel claim, and how to delete unwanted claims. Let's get started by setting up claimant defaults. Claimant defaults are used to automatically populate claimant data when you create a claim. Any information contained in the claimant defaults or claimant defaults 2 panels will be reflected in mileage or travel claims that are created when the claimant is selected. Once you have logged on to PeopleSoft, you can find the mileage and travel panel by clicking on Go, Mileage and Travel. To access claimant defaults, click on Setup, Claimant Defaults, Claimant Defaults, Update, Display. All claimant names are listed last name first in capital letters. To find a claimant, click on the Name 1 field and you can type the whole last name or partial last name in capital letters and click on Search. A list of results will display with the criteria you have entered. Double-click on the name you wish to view to open this claimant's information. If this is the first time you are setting up a claimant, all of the fields except for the effective date and status will be blank. So go ahead and fill in the entire claimant's information. The effective date should be overridden to be effective the first day of the fiscal year. If you are editing an existing user, you will need to insert a new row by pressing the F7 key or use the Insert Row icon to create a new panel to update the user's information. The user's previous information is populated from the old data, but the effective date will update to today's date. When editing a claimant, please set their effective date accordingly, usually to the effective date of the changed data, such as a new assignment. If you are unable to enter the effective date you need, please contact Internal System Support. Once you have filled out the claimant's information, click on the Claimant Defaults 2 tab. Here you will find the mileage and travel account string selections, referred to as speed charts. This information will automatically populate the account code defaults tab of a claim. Although not required, we recommend that you have a speed chart set for each claimant. To set a speed chart, click on the drop-down arrow next to mileage or travel to bring up the speed chart selection window. Search for the speed chart you wish to use by typing in the speed chart code or scrolling to find it. Speed charts are made up of 5 alphanumeric characters. Mileage speed charts will start with an M, and travel speed charts will begin with a T, followed by a sequence of 4 digits that define the location used in the account string. If multiple speed charts exist that use the same location, the last number of the location will be replaced by a letter. Due to this naming sequence, best practice is to type only the first 3 to 4 characters of the 5 characters when searching for a speed chart. An example of this is the mileage speed chart for location 3711. If we search for M371, we will see that there are several different speed charts for this location listed. Once you find the speed chart you are looking for, select it and click OK. If you do not see the speed chart you need, please email Internal System Support and we will assist you. After selecting the speed chart, pressing the Tab key will populate the speed chart details. After you have finished updating all the claimant data, you can press the Save button. If you close the claimant defaults panels, you will not be able to change them without creating a new panel with the F7 key and specifying a new effective date. Now that the claimant defaults have been established, we are ready to create a mileage or travel claim. To create a mileage claim, navigate to Go, Mileage and Travel, Use Mileage Claim Mileage Add. Do not change any information on this window. All claims, whether mileage or travel, must be automatically assigned a claim ID to avoid duplicate claim IDs. Leaving the claim ID as Next allows PeopleSoft to assign the next available claim ID to your new claim when you click the Save button on the claim panel. So please just click OK to continue creating the claim. The Mileage tab consists of four main sections: Claim Header Information, Claimant Information, Processing Buttons, Line Details, where all the claims are listed. You can also see the Workflow Status, Total Miles, Parking Fees, Mileage Amount, and Total Payments to be Made. Choose a claimant by clicking on the drop-down arrow next to claimant. Search for a claimant in the same manner as you did when setting up the defaults. Last name first, all in capital letters. Select the claimant and click OK. If you are unable to find the claimant, please send an email to Internal System Support and we can add them to your list of claimants if they are established as an employee vendor. After you've made your selection, when you hit the tab or select a new field, the information that you set in the claimant defaults will auto-populate the user's information in the claim. If you click on the Defaults tab, you will notice the speed chart that was set up on the Claimant Defaults 2 tab will have populated this area as well. If you need to charge a different account for this claim, you can type in a new account code. However, be aware that changing the account code default will only affect new lines created on the Mileage tab. Changing the account code default will not change any lines that have already been created. Back on the Mileage tab, you will need to set a claim date. Click on the drop-down arrow and pick the last day of the month this claim is for. Once the claim date is set, it's time to create claim items. This section is fairly self-explanatory. Choose the date and complete the From and To fields. CMD stands for Commuter Miles Deduction. Only check this option if the claimant traveled to or from their place of residence. Checking CMD does not affect the mileage calculation. Instead, you will be responsible for deducting the claimant's commuter miles from the claim. If you click on the small icon at the end of the line, you will find the accounts from the Defaults tab listed here. To add an additional line item, press the F7 key while having a line selected. If you need to delete a line, press the F8 key or the Delete Row icon to remove the line you currently have selected. Once you have finished adding lines, press the Save icon to save your claim. You will see that your claim ID will change from Next to a number. You can use this number to access this claim again in the future. Additionally, the Budget Check and Print icons will become available. Click on the Budget Check icon. This will change the status from not checked to valid. If the budget is not valid, you will receive an error message describing the error and the status will change to error. If you get a budget check error, you can try resolving it by checking a couple of things. First, check if the account string is valid by verifying the speed chart you are using. Second, check if the account has enough funds in it by accessing your account through the site budget inquiry. For further instruction on Site Budget Inquiry, please see our Site Budget Inquiry training video. If you are unable to resolve the error on your own, please contact Internal System Support and we will assist you. If necessary, you can print the mileage claim by clicking on the Print icon. This will open an Adobe Acrobat Reader, and you can print a copy by clicking on the Print icon. With budget status as valid, you can now send the claim for approval. Click on the Approval Send button. Click Yes at the prompt to send this claim for approval. The screen will now change to the Inquiry screen, which is a read-only version of the claim. The Inquiry screen includes a new tab, Approval History. Here you can check the status of a claim's approval. No further changes can be made to the mileage claim once it has been sent for approval. If you need to edit or delete the claim, you can perform a workflow reset by pressing the WF Reset button on the Approval History tab. There are a few things to consider when editing or deleting a claim. A claim must not be in workflow. If it is in workflow, meaning pending approval status, you will need to deny the claim or reset the workflow. Then, you will need to go to LACOE Workflow Approvals and click Worked on the claim. Also, the claim must not have been paid or vouchered. If it has been vouchered, please contact Accounts Payable and they will assist you. Once the workflow has been reset on a claim, you will need to go to LACOE Workflow Approvals and click Worked. If you skip this step, you will be unable to edit or delete your claim. To find this, navigate to Go, LACOE Workflow Approvals, then click Use, Worklist, Mileage Claim. You will see the claim listed here. Click the Worked checkbox and click the Save icon. Now that the claim has been worked, you can access it again in the Mileage and Travel Use panel. Navigate again to Go, Mileage and Travel, Use, Mileage Claim, Update Display. You can type in the claim ID without the leading zeros to find your claim, or you can search by name. Select the claim and click OK to open. If you are only making changes, go ahead and make the changes required on the claim, then run Budget Check and send for approval. If you are deleting a claim, you can click on the trash can icon located to the right of the workflow status. Now, we will explore how to create a travel claim. To create a new travel claim, navigate to Go, Mileage and Travel, then click on Use, Travel Claim, Header, Add. Click OK at this screen again without changing any of the defaults. The biggest difference between mileage and travel claim panels is the lines are found on a separate tab labeled Lines, rather than on the Header tab. On the Header tab, choose the claimant the same as you did for the mileage. Click on the drop-down arrow next to claimant. Find the claimant you wish to use, searching by last name, in caps. Click OK, and the claimant information will automatically populate once you click away from the claimant field. The claim date must be after the completion of travel. Now complete the board date, travel location, conference title, departure date and time, return date and time, number of non-business days, commuter miles, if any, and any advance money given to the traveler. Once the header tab is completed, move to the lines tab. Here you will find line items for each week of claims. The weeks will display from Sunday to Saturday. You will need to choose the date of the Sunday of the week you are claiming. For example, if the start of travel is on Thursday, October 11th, you will need to select October 7th as the Sunday. If there are multiple weeks, you will need to use the outer scroll bar to switch between weeks. The inner scroll bar is used to scroll through line items. By clicking one of the scroll bars, you will change your active panel. By default, you will be using the inner scroll bar that edits line items. First, click the down arrow in the box labeled Item ID. Choose the line item type and click OK. You only need to choose one item for the entire week's worth. If you notice, only the days that the travel happened will become fillable. Add claim amounts for each day needed. To add another line, press the F7 key and repeat the steps to complete the claim data. If the travel spanned two or more weeks, please click the outer scroll bar and press the F7 key. This will create an additional week that you can add additional claim items for. Once you have completed the claim lines, press the Save icon to save your changes and assign the claim a claim ID number. Go back to the Header tab, and you will notice the Budget Check icon has become available. Now follow the same process as you did for mileage claims. Click the Print button to print your claim. Then press the Budget Check icon to validate the claim's account. Once the claim has passed Budget Check, click the Approval Send button to send the claim into Workflow for approval. As with mileage claims, you will be taken to the Inquiry screen as no further changes are allowed. Again, if you need to make changes or delete your claim, you can click on the WF Reset icon to reset workflow found in the Approval History tab. After you've reset workflow, or if your claim is denied, you will need to go to the LACOE Workflow Approvals under Travel Claims and click on Worked before you can make any changes. Again, this is found by navigating to Go, LACOE Workflow Approvals, Use, Worklist, and Travel Claims. Click on the Worked checkbox, then hit the Save button. You can then open your claim by navigating to Mileage and Travel, Use, Travel Claim, Header, Update Display. Input the claim ID you wish to edit, or click Search to display all claims available to you. Choose your claim and click OK. Here, you can now edit your claim and process for approval again by clicking the Budget Check icon after you complete your changes, and click Approval Send to submit to workflow. If you need to delete the claim, simply press the trash can icon and press OK at the prompt. By logging on to LACOE Employee Intranet, you can find additional PeopleSoft training videos, in-class instruction scheduling, and user manuals. You can also view our schedule of classes on the calendar by choosing ISS Training from the list of categories on the staff calendar. Additional training videos and user manuals can be found by clicking on Business Services, then Internal Systems Support on the navigation menu. If you have any questions or need further assistance, please feel free to contact Internal Systems Support. You can reach us by emailing internalsystemssupport@laco.edu. Thank you.